Hello all, welcome back to Let's Shoot. Suppose you have made an investment of 100 each in two companies. The first one you sold it off after 1 year at 200. And second one also you sold it off at 200, but after 3 years. So here the profits earned on both is 100 each. Now can you say you have earned the same returns on both the investments? Maybe yes, if we see the profit amounts. But what about the years of holding the investments? That should also be considered, right? And that is what we are going to discuss in today's session. So friends, after learning how to calculate and analyze various accounting and financial ratios like liquidity ratios, leverage ratios covering capital structure and coverage ratios, activity ratios and profitability ratios based on sales, today we are going to understand the second type of profitability ratios that are related to overall return on assets or investments. Before we go ahead, if you are new to our channel, do hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notification of new videos uploaded. And if you are looking for online courses, then do check out our website where there are various courses available at very affordable prices. Now let's start with today's session. Suppose you have invested your money in any company, then what's the basic thing you would look for? Yes, how much profit the company has made? Or how much you have earned on your investments, right? Similarly, in any company, the shareholders or investors or other interested parties would want to know how much return they get from their investments, which can be found out by calculating return on investment ratio. It is the percentage of return on the funds invested in the business. This helps to evaluate how well an investment has performed. The formula to calculate return on investment is returns or profits or earnings divided by cost of investment or the current value of investment less cost of investment divided by the cost of investment multiplied by 100, that is measured as a percentage. Suppose an investor earned a profit of 30 on an investment of 100, then that means his ROI is 30%. Similarly, in the example we discussed at the start, earning 100 on investment of 100 gives us a return on investment of 100%. So in both companies, our returns are 100%. Isn't this one of the simplest ratios to calculate? And so it is used widely by everyone to compare and judge their investments. Also, return from different investments can be easily compared by comparing their ROI. Investments with positive ROI would be probably worthwhile, and investors should avoid negative ROIs, which imply a net loss. But however, this ratio does have flaws as it does not take time into account. Let's understand by an example. Suppose there are two companies, A and B. We made an investment in A worth 5,000 and sold it off after 3 years for 7,000. So here, the return earned is 2,000, giving a return on investment of 40%. Now say in company B, we made an investment of 8,000 and sold off after 5 years at 11,200. Here, the return earned is 3,200. And what will be the ROI? Yes, it is coming same 40%. So it seems that we have earned the same return in both companies, right? But can you note something here? To earn a 40% return, the time period for which investments are held in company A is 3 years, while in company B is 5 years. Thus, the ROI has not taken into account the holding period or the passage of time. And so, to avoid this limitation, annualized ROI can be taken into account. The one which earns more annually will be more profitable than the other. The annualized return can be calculated as 1 plus profit or returns divided by cost of investment, whole raised to 1 by n, whole minus 1 multiplied by 100. Here, N represents the number of years the investment is held. Now, can you try calculating annualized return for companies A and B using this formula? Firstly, for company A, 1 plus 2000 divided by 5000, that is 40% being the ROI, raised to 1 by 3, the whole minus 1 multiplied by 100, which comes to 11.87%. And similarly, for company B, it comes to 6.96%, considering 5 years for which investment is held. Thus, even with the same ROIs of 40% for both companies, the investment held in company A is more profitable than company B as it has earned more returns annually. Let's calculate annualized ROI for the example we discussed at the start. For first company, annualized ROI comes to 100%, which is the same as ROI as the period of holding the investment is only 1 year. So return on investment is the annual return on investment. Now for second company, ROI is 100%, but annualized ROI comes to 25.99% as the period of holding the investment is 3 years. And thus, we earn less annually in second company compared to first company, though both gave the same returns of 100%. So now, have you all understood why the basic formula for ROI needs to be modified to consider the time factor to get a more precise value of return on investments? Friends, on the basis of different aspects, we can calculate these return on investment ratios, which we shall discuss in our upcoming sessions. And if you found this video useful, do like, comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe. And also do check out our online courses on accounts, GST, Excel, Tally, and many more, enrolled by thousands of learners across the globe, available at very affordable prices on our website. So see you all in the next session. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.